My name is Sophie Miller, and I'm a major in English Literature here at college. My thesis focuses on the difference between childhood and children in the literature of popular children's author Roald Dahl. When I envisioned writing my thesis on Roald Dahl, I thought that I would be reinvesting myself and my academic energies in the writing of an author that I loved for the entire time that I was growing up. Instead, I ended up dismantling my childhood. I began by examining the criticism that surrounds Dahl's extensive body of work. Children's literature critics fall into two major camps on Dahl. They either demonize him as totally antagonistic towards all children, citing the scariness and grotesqueness of his books, or they laud him as a hero and advocate for children everywhere. But in rereading my favorites of Dahl's books, I noticed a distinction between an abstract idea of childhood and the actual children that he writes into his novels. Dahl certainly supports the abstract idea and the sacred nature of this idea of childhood, which is a popular conception in Western culture. He focuses, for instance, in most of his popular books on the delights of magic or candy. But this sanctity and this protection of this sanctity of the idea of childhood does not follow through in the way that Dahl portrays the characters and the child characters that he writes into his books. Take, for example, this little guy right here. You might recognize him. This is Augustus Gloop, who is one of four horrific child characters from Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. He is famously gluttonous, a trait that results in his falling face first into a chocolate river and being sucked up into the interior machinery of Willy Wonka's factory. All of the spoiled and selfish child characters in Charlie and the Chocolate Factory meet a similar and clearly very dangerous end, and every time Dahl makes sure to assert that the child's fate was well deserved by them, and his books abound with these nasty child characters. This rupture between the magic of the idea of childhood and the nastiness of the children themselves creates an uneasy contradiction between our perception of Dahl as either purely good or purely malicious as a children's author. So the question then becomes, should we be reading Roald Dahl to our children? Even his staunchest advocates in the world of literary criticism admit that his books are awfully dark for young readers. But if I've learned one thing from writing this thesis and from taking apart my childhood, it's that where the young magic of these books had dissipated for me a little bit, new adult wonders grew up in their place. As we grow up and as we mature, we learn that childhood isn't always magical, and that magic isn't always good. Dahl understood this lesson, and he preserved it in his books until his readers are old enough to understand it as well. Thank you.